Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 6.1, Problem 3. This is Section 6.1, Problem number 3. It says, consider the experiment of rolling a single die, not a pair of dice, a single die. A, construct a probability distribution, B, draw the histogram, and C, find the mean. So, for the probability distribution, a probability distribution is a chart with two columns. The first column we label X, and it lists every possible outcome for your experiment. And the second column we label P parentheses X for probability of X. So, for this experiment of rolling a single die, what's every single outcome you can have? It's 1 through 6, so if you picture what the die would look like, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. These are all the outcomes. So for the first column of my probability distribution, I'll put in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's every outcome I can get. That's what goes in the first column. Now, for the probability of each one, well, what's the probability of getting a 1? There's one way to get a 1 out of 6 rolls you can get all together, so it's 1 over 6. As a decimal, you could divide 1 divided by 6, and it's 0.16666. The 6's never repeat. Or you can leave 1 over 6. Probability of getting a 2. Well, again, there's one roll that gives you 2 out of 6 altogether. It's also going to be 1 out of 6. The same thing for a 3. There's one roll that gives you a 3 out of 6 rolls altogether, so the probability that you get a 3 is 1 over 6. Same for a 4. One roll that gives you a 4 out of 6 rolls altogether. Again, the same for a 5. There's one roll that gives you a 5 out of 6 rolls altogether. And finally for a 6, there's one roll that gives you a 6 out of 6 rolls altogether. So that's part A. Construct a probability distribution. So there it is, your chart with two columns. The first column lists every possible outcome you can have for your experiment, 1 through 6. And the second column lists the probabilities of everything in the first column. So each roll is 1 over 6. So B, draw the histogram. Now a histogram, again, is a special bar graph for a probability distribution. The bars will have to be vertical, they'll have to touch. So let's make a bar graph. And so for our probability up the side here, we can have, well, let's say 1 over 6, 2 over 6, 3 over 6, 4 over 6. So you could label it with decimals also. So the probability of getting a 1, 1 over 6. And that's the outcome goes right under the center of that first bar. Probability of getting a 2, also height is 1 over 6, same for a 3, same height for a 4. Same height again for a 5. They're all the same 1 over 6 height. So the bar graph, or histogram, would have 6 bars all at the same height of 1 over 6, or 0.1666 if you want decimals. And it would look kind of flat and very uniform. And then C, find the mean. So again, the mean, the average value, if you roll that single die millions of times, take the results, add them up, divide by the millions of rolls, what would it be? Well, what you're going to do to get that, you could roll the die millions of times and do that math, which would give you the right answer, but it'd be too tedious. The other way to get the same answer is multiply everything in the first column times its probability and add those results together. So 1 times 1 over 6 is 1 over 6. 2 times 1 over 6 would be 2 over 6. Now I can reduce that, but I'm going to want to keep all the denominators the same for when I add them up at the end. So yes, it does reduce to 1/3, but I want everything with the same denominator. So the next row down, the number in the first column, 3, times its probability, which is also 1 over 6, multiplies to 3 over 6, which again can reduce, but I don't want to. The next row down, the number in the first column is 4, times its probability, times 1 over 6, would give me a 4 over 6. Which again, we'll reduce, but I want to leave all the denominators as 6. The next row down, the number in the first column is 5 times its probability, 1 over 6, would be 5 over 6. That does not reduce. And finally, the last one, the number in the first column is 6 times its probability, which is also 1 over 6, would be 6 over 6. Again, it reduces to 1, but I want to leave everything with the same denominator, because now to finish my mean of a probability distribution, what I have to do is add these together. So 1 over 6 plus 2 over 6 plus 3 over 6 plus 4 over 6 plus 5 over 6 plus 6 over 6. My common denominator is 6, so if I add the numerators, 1 and 2 is 3, 3 and 3 is 6, 6 and 4 is 10, 10 and 5 is 15, 15 and 6 is 21. 21 over 6. Now that I can reduce. They both, 3 goes into both evenly. So 3 goes into 21 7 times, 3 goes into 6 twice. So 7 halves, which would reduce to 3.5, or 3.5 if you like decimals better than fractions. These are all the same. So if you rolled your single die millions of times, kept track of the results you got, and then divided by the millions of rolls you may have thrown, that average would come out to 3.5. Or you can get that same answer in a minute or two just by multiplying every number in the first column times its probability, taking the answers and adding them together. Get the same answer.